Are you curious about the ideal number of push-ups to build muscle? Well, let's explore a method for performing push-ups that guarantees visible results. Be sure to watch this video till the end, because I'll share a push-up regimen aimed at enhancing muscle growth at any fitness level. Push-ups primarily target the chest, shoulders, and triceps, but also they engage a range of other muscles throughout the body. The core, including the abs and lower back, is engaged to maintain body alignment throughout the movement. The legs and glutes are also activated to provide support and stability. Thus, push-ups offer a full-body workout, making them an efficient choice for those seeking to maximize their exercise time. Push-ups also have cardiovascular benefits. Performing push-ups at a moderate to high intensity can increase heart rate and help improve cardiovascular health over time. Push-ups can also contribute to improved flexibility. The movements of lowering and raising the body during a push-up stretches and contracts various muscles, promoting flexibility and range of motion. This can lead to improved performance as well as a reduced risk of injury. Push-ups can help improve bone health. By stressing the bones, push-ups stimulate the growth of new bone tissue, making the bones stronger and denser. The most important thing: daily push-ups are not optimal for muscle growth. When you do strength exercises such as push-ups, you cause small tears in your muscle fibers. It's very important to give muscles sufficient time to recover. If you don't give them enough time to recover, it can lead to overtraining or even injuries. Proper rest is very important for muscle repair and growth. During periods of rest or sleep, your body acts as a mender, repairing those tears and propelling your muscles to a new level. This phenomenon is known as muscular hypertrophy. When you perform push-ups, your muscles undergo intense exertion. They dynamically contract against your body weight, enduring both tension and resistance. These movements provide an exceptional workout for your triceps, deltoids, and pecs. Also, your muscles resist gravity. All this leads to those tiny micro-tears. So, how your body responds to these micro-tears? It ramps up hormone production and allocates additional resources to repair these muscles. So, your muscle fibers mend and return stronger and larger. The real muscle-building process occurs during rest periods after your workout. During this time, your body increases hormone production and initiates muscular protein synthesis. Without the necessary rest, it will not occur. So, you need for rest to allow muscle growth, rather than continuous damage. So, how many push-ups should you do to make progress? The optimal number of push-ups is based on your fitness level. If you're a beginner, you should do one less push-up than your max. If your maximum is 8 push-ups, do 7 push-ups in each set. Perform 3-4 sets of 6 to 10 reps. If you're a completely beginner and can't do even one push-up, try to do knee push-ups. If you're intermediate or advanced athlete, try to perform 3-4 sets of 15 to 25 reps. Moreover, you can set a challenge. Perform as many reps as possible. This will surprise your muscles and keep them toned. In addition, you can add push-up variations to your training program. For example, clapping push-ups, knuckle push-ups, or incline push-ups. Let's design a push-up program to enhance muscle growth. You need to keep balance of volume and sets. Consider your maximum push-up count, then reduce it by 2 to 3 reps. Keep the sets to a moderate, 3 to 4 to protect your joints. Push-ups shouldn't dominate your workout routine. Push-ups can be the main compound exercise or a supporting act to main exercises like the bench press. Always initiate your workout with high-energy compound exercises followed by isolation exercises. Best time to do push-ups based on individual preference. For best results, I suggest doing push-ups about 1 to 2 hours after having a meal, reaching carbohydrates to optimize your performance. Regarding recovery time, muscles may require up to 48 hours to fully recuperate from an intense workout. Therefore, plan your push-up days with rest days in between. Now let's discuss nutrition. If you don't consume sufficient protein and maintain a slight calorie surplus, your efforts may not produce the desired results. Target an intake of approximately 1 to 2 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight and aim for a calorie surplus of 200 to 500 calories. How to perform push-ups correctly? Start in a high plank position. Place your palms flat on the ground, hands shoulder-width apart with shoulders stacked directly above your wrists. Keep your body in a straight line from the top of your head through to your heels. Your feet can be hip-width apart for better balance. Begin to lower your body towards the ground. Keep your elbows close to the body for a standard push-up. Lower yourself until your chest nearly touches the floor. Ensure that you maintain the alignment of your body. Push your body up, returning to the starting position. Keep your core engaged and maintain the straight line of your body. Inhale as you lower your body and exhale as you push back up to the starting position. Share your current push-up record in the comments below and be sure to watch other videos. Bye!